with me now. Come with me now.
Good morning, Wolfpack. I'm Ross Allen.
And I'm Geneva Ross. Today is Monday, January 9th, and we're here with your morning announcements.
Let's kick off today's show by taking a look at the Buddy Project and the impact it has on campus.
Hello, Wolfpack. I'm Jordan Corder, and today I'm here with the President and Vice President of the Buddy Club to talk about their involvement with the school.
Hi, guys. My name is Natalie Parker, and I'm the President of Buddy Project.
My name's Sam. I'm Vice President.
So, basically, Buddy Project is a club that we have on campus, and we meet up in Miss Trina's room, HH8, and we meet up the second and the fourth Thursday of every month during Wolfpack Hour. And basically what we do is we go in and hang out with the special ed kids, and we do arts and crafts with them and get to know them better, and it's a lot of fun, so I hope to see you guys all there. Mm-hmm. Do you think everyone should join?
No.
Reporting for Wolfpack TV with filmographers Jacob Corder and Brian Robert, I'm Jordan Corder. Back to you, anchors.
The Buddy Project looks awesome. They should be proud of all the work they have done. Now here are some club announcements.
FBLA members, your next meeting is this Friday the 13th till 4 o'clock. If you have any questions, please see an FBLA officer.
Sophomores, juniors, and seniors, if you are interested in joining CSF for terms 3 and 4, applications are due by Friday, January 20th, and can be found in the library.
Speaking of the library, our librarians have asked us to remind you that if you have any overdue books, you will be placed on the no activities list. As always, you must have an ID card to check out library books.
Lead Latino Club members, there is a mandatory meeting on Wednesday, the 11th at 3:20 in HM1.
The Ultimate Frisbee Club is hosting a game every other Wednesday for Term 3. The games will start this Wednesday from 3:30 to 4:30. Make sure to bring shoes or cleats, one white shirt and one dark shirt, and they will be meeting on the practice fields. And with that, let's pass on over to Carly and Miranda for your bi-weekly news update.
Hey there, Wolfpack. I'm Carly Johnson.
And I'm Miranda Chabot, and we're back with your weekly news update.
Let's start off today with a local controversy. If you are looking forward to post-holiday shopping spree, you may have to wait until your 18th birthday. Art and Fair Mall in Sacramento has instituted a new policy, giving them the right to turn away unaccompanied minors on busy days. They claim this rule will prevent fights which break out around the holidays across the country, usually provoked by teenagers.
Unsurprisingly, this ban has received a huge backlash from teens and parents alike, who find the policy not just unfair, but discriminatory. Some claim that the practice has led to racial profiling, with teens of color being turned away more often. Even the American Civil Liberties Union has issued a statement denouncing the policy for discriminating against an entire age group.
Only time will tell if this rule will stop fights or just simply hurt the mall's revenue.
Now let's shift over to political news. The nation's biggest concern over the last few months has been Russian hacking during the recent presidential election. When we say hacking, it does not mean that Russia rigged the votes of the election. Russia hacked our election by revealing information that attempted to sway voters at critical times. Controversy surrounds the necessary actions that need to be taken to keep our country safe.
President Obama responded by issuing an executive order that provides additional authority for responding to certain cyber activity that seeks to interfere with or undermine our election processes and institutions, or those of our allies and partners. Obama expelled 35 Russian intelligence officials and imposed sanctions. Some news sources, such as Fox News, claims that President Obama did not do enough to retaliate against Russia. It is up to you to decide if you think his actions were justified. Seeing as this story is still developing, we'll be sure to keep you posted.
Well, that's all the news we have for you today. I'm Miranda Chabot.
And I'm Carly Johnson. See you on Wednesday, Wolfpack.
If you are interested in playing softball, there is a mandatory meeting in room L3 today from 3:30 to 4 o'clock.
And don't forget, Wolfpack, to send your fellows from Overbreak using the hashtag WPTV for a chance to be on our show this Friday.
Kicking off the new year is Week of Awareness. The goal for this week is to spread awareness for various unheard issues.
As you may know, today's topic is cyberbullying prevention. Let's take a look at a PSA done by our very own broadcasting students. That was a really powerful message.
I agree. Remember, Wolfpack, to watch what you say online.
Don't forget, tomorrow, choose a cause you support and represent it.
And on Wednesday, just be you. This is your day to be your true self. Thursday will be mental health awareness, and Friday will be We Are One Day. Wear orange to show that we stand as one.
Well, that's all we have for you today, guys. I'm Ross Allen.
And I'm Geneva Ross. Remember, the strength of the pack is the wolf.
And the strength of the wolf is the pack. Great job, Powderpuff.
Jealous keep my picture frames and everything did oxidate in place. But then